current account deficit, while Europe and Japan run a surplus. And over time, the larger US fiscal deficit is gonna make this current account deficit even larger. And the latest number just came out, have shown that actually the US trade deficit is becoming bigger. You know, until the Fed was raising rates, you could finance these large twin deficits with a stronger dollar. But once you cut rates to zero and you do QE, then the force that was keeping the dollar stronger in spite of twin fiscal current account deficit goes away. There are also geopolitical factors that are bearing on the US dollar. A number of countries are worried that the US is weaponizing the US dollar. It might seize their assets, if not default on them. It's a risk that has been directly already faced, of course, by Iran or Korea, but now the Chinese or the Russian are worried also about that. And some people in Congress say we should punish China by freezing their holdings of reserves. So China is gradually deciding to reduce their holdings of dollar assets, and they're going not into other currencies or in their own one because it would appreciate their currency. They're going into gold. So this weaponization of the US dollar gradually is going to imply that other countries may want to reduce their holdings of dollar. And of course, until recently, we were in risk on rather than risk off. And when risk is on, people tend to move away from dollar into other assets, including even the currencies of some of these emerging markets that they've been strengthening. And of course, in March and February, we had a massive amount of dollar illiquidity. But given the QE of the Fed, given the swap lines with central banks, both in advanced economies and emerging market, and even some repo lines with some emerging markets, that risk of dollar illiquidity that was leading people to try to hedge their dollar debts is now reduced, and emerging markets are improving. And therefore, that has been weakening the dollar. Of course, if this correction in equity market were to occur, if we're gonna go back to another period of risk off, if we're gonna have a slowdown of growth, if we're gonna have a second wave, then if we're gonna go back to risk off rather than risk on, then people may seek the safety of the US dollar in spite of these fundamentals that are bearing down on the dollar. But on a medium term basis, I would say the dollar can weaken gradually. Some people say the US dollar is done, is gonna lose its role as the major reserve currency. The problem is that you cannot substitute something with nothing, and there is not a clear alternative to the US dollar. What could be the alternative? The euro, the yen, the pound, gold, unlikely, cryptocurrencies, even less likely, the RMB maybe in the very long term, but not in the short run.